Right, we're going to talk about trees now, the lungs of the world. They take in CO2, they store the carbon, they give out oxygen. So if we have deforestation, you can imagine potentially the impact on the environment. With me here in the studio is Dr. Tom Crowther, Professor for Global Ecosystem Ecology at ETH Zurich and Chief Scientific Advisor to the UN's Trillion Tree Campaign. My goodness, that is some job description. You're a busy, busy man, but the perfect man for me to ask where we're up to in terms of our relationship with the environment at the moment.
Yeah, our relationship with the environment's an interesting one. I feel like until now, humanity has done an excellent job of colonizing and dominating space and making the most of all the resources that we have at our expense. So we, you know, we use about 70% of the land surface to some degree in terms of using it for agriculture or resources. And we've actually cut down almost half of the world's trees that would have existed before the agricultural revolution. So we've had an absolutely dominant impact on our planet. And now is a critical time for us to start turning that around. The processes that we've set in place, like climate change, and also feedbacks to climate change, are quite concerning. And the process is now accelerating. And it's now time that we start to work more sort of holistically with natural ecosystems if we're going to be able to, you know, manage those global threats of biodiversity loss and climate change into the future.
So that all makes sense. And yet, in the Amazon basin, they're still destroying the forests, they're burning them. How hopeful are you that we are going to waken up to this?
I mean, it's a really concerning thing, mainly because these fires, the spike in fires is strongly related to changes in political decisions. So when you sort of remove the pressures or remove the limits that people have to do slash and burn forest removal, then of course humans are going to be using that forest for their livelihoods. But it's worth noting that fires are a natural process, and there are huge spikes and variations in fire prevalence every single year. And while this is an extreme year, certainly forests will recover and ecosystems will be able to respond and adapt. And it's not the end of the world. What we need to do is try to stop this systemic increase in land use that humans are having. And then, if we possibly can, really turn the dial so we can actually start to increase the coverage of those natural ecosystems. Because we've got the technology and the options available to us.
Yeah, but you see, there's a bit of a dichotomy here. We're told that we have to feed 9.8 billion people by the year 2050. We need more land, and yet you're saying use less land. So how do you square that up?
Well, that is a growing concern that, you know, our growing human population is going to require more and more and more resources, understandably. But that's the importance of coming to places like this. When we come to Bühler and we talk with the agricultural sector, we can see that there's so many places where innovation can improve the efficiency of the agricultural process so that you can double the amount of produce for half the amount of land. And those innovations can be absolutely transformative in our ability to use ecosystems and work with those ecosystems to have a sustainable future.
So Bühler is an important catalyst to bring people like yourselves together with industry.
I think that's a good point. I work very much in the natural ecosystem. So I'm into natural regeneration of ecosystems to their greatest extent, because our research is showing they have an incredible power to draw down carbon from the atmosphere and slow the rate of climate change. But of course, industry and agriculture are our main users of natural resources. And you know, I benefit from it, you benefit from it. We all drove here this morning. It's absolutely necessary for human growth and the enjoyment of our lives to have that effective and efficient agricultural and industrial systems. So the real value of Bühler is, you know, being that central point that they can have an impact on the entire agricultural system. And if we can have even 1, 5, 10% increases in the efficiency of the entire agricultural system, the impacts can be astronomical in combination with natural regeneration, which is what I do.
Right. Explain to me what exactly the UN's Trillion Tree Campaign is. You're a scientific advisor to it. What does that involve?
So essentially, there's been a lot of initiatives that are trying to promote restoration of ecosystems. And a while ago, the UN's Billion Tree Campaign was launched in combination with an organization called Plant for the Planet. And they're a crazy group of essentially thousands of children around the world doing sort of advocacy and trying to get their local communities to plant trees. It's amazing. And so Plant for the Planet sort of took over that project. But in the process, I started working with them, and our research started to show us that a billion trees would be nice, but it's nowhere near the scale of the problem we've got. Until now, we've lost about 2.8 trillion trees. There's still 3 trillion trees left on the planet, but we've had a huge impact. And if we want to really, you know, make a dent in the current trend, we need to be scaling that billion trees up to a trillion tree campaign. So the goal is now to inspire restoration all across the globe. And it's really exciting. Our recent research shows that if we achieved that, we could capture a huge chunk, maybe even 2/3 of the excess carbon that's remaining in the atmosphere because of human activity. And that would make it one of our most, if not our most powerful tool in the fight against climate change. So it's like, it's just the beginning of an emergence of thousands of projects dotting up around the world, restoring ecosystems to have amazing impacts on local communities, biodiversity, and climate.
It sounds big, almost overwhelming. And I'm wondering what an individual like myself can do. I'm just one little person on this globe. What difference can I make?
Yeah, actually, that's a really good question, because the whole point of this is that we can all get engaged. I think the biggest challenge we have in the climate crisis is figuring out how the billions of people on this planet can get engaged, because most of us understand about climate change and we're worried about the effects, but we don't know what to do. And the nice thing here is we're not trying to have a few massive projects where governments or companies do something enormous. We need millions of little projects. We need individuals across the world either planting trees or simply donating to the thousands of projects that are already restoring ecosystems. So, you know, with the click of a button, you can come onto our map. You can see lots of dots on the map. You just click on a dot and you can donate as much money as you want to restore trees or restore wetlands in those right ecosystems. Or if you don't even want to go that detailed, just be mindful of your investments. So if you're buying things or investing your money, selecting companies that have a minimal environmental impact or even a positive environmental impact can really start to shape the market, and you can have an incredibly tangible effect by just doing that.
Well, let's wrap up by asking you, putting you on the spot, in fact, if I may, how confident are you, scale of 1 to 10, that we can solve this problem that we as individuals, industries like Bühler are involved in, that globally, governments, that we can actually waken up and do something about this?
I'm certain we can do something. The extent to what we'll achieve is still a big question mark. And to be honest, that's not a problem. I love the challenge. You wouldn't play a game where you knew the answer. This is an incredibly exciting challenge, just because anything is possible. You know, we're showing what's physically possible on the planet. We know that by restoring ecosystems, we can have a massive impact. By improving efficiency of agriculture, we can have a massive impact. Those are the full potentials. All I can say is I'm going to get stuck in and fight as hard as I can to get as much of that potential as we can. If we achieved even 10% of it, it'd be spectacular. And I think the sky's our limit.
So it's not the only game in town, but it's obviously a very important one. Tom, thanks for joining us.
Thank you so much.